through his shed blood for us. Because of his sacrifice and his paying, we can have peace with God, and that peace can flow into every aspect that we have. The kingdom described in chapter 11 is not here on this earth, but it is our home. You may have a passport. You may have a driver's license that says you are a citizen of this country. But as believers, we are citizens of an eternal country, of an eternal home. That is where our true home is. That is where true peace is to be found. The kingdom here is the kingdom where we belong. And Jesus has gone to prepare a place in that kingdom for us. If we have been reconciled to him, if we have chosen to believe in him and chosen to turn our lives over to him and chosen to make him our king, then we can start living in that kingdom. Even now, we can have that peace that passes all understanding. Again, it's now and it's not yet. It's not yet in all of its fullness. We see in a mirror dimly all of those verses that say, you have some of it, but you don't have all of it. We look forward to that day when we will have all of it. But we also know that we can have it right now. You can have peace this Christmas, at least in a measure, because you have at peace with Jesus Christ. God has promised us a peaceful kingdom. He is our King, and we follow him. And because we follow him, we know that our fundamental nature has been changed. But we also know that we have a long way to go. It's both now and not yet. We know that we're forgiven from our sins, but we also know that we still have sin in our lives. We look forward to that day, but we also act on the fact that we are cleansed, that we are forgiven, and that peace can flow out into all of the relationships that we have. If you do not know Jesus Christ as your Savior, we would love to have you have the peace that passes all understanding and introduce you to that great King who can bring peace to you, who can bring his life to you. We'd love to do that. We've got potluck afterwards. You can find me or you can find one of the deacons. You can talk to your parents. But we can have peace this Christmas as a start, as a now, even as we wait for the peace that will come when Jesus Christ returns. Let's bow in prayer. Father, we want to thank you that you have promised us peace and that you give us peace. We know that we have peace through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who died for us. Lord, we know that we have peace with you, but we also know that we continue to sin. We thank you that we no longer are judged, but we also realize that sometimes we need to be discipled, that we need to be disciplined. Lord, we pray that you would help us to realize that we can have that peace that comes from the presence of the Holy Spirit, the peace that comes because we are reconciled to the Father. And Lord, we pray that that would affect our Christmas and our world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Sing.